Chapter 12. This is a very intimate friend of mine. His surname is Kuli, named Buku. On the wooden sides of the table, formerly on the spot where Kuli Buku sat, two words were carved by fingernails, plum blossom. Judging by the strength that the commander asserted to write those words, it seems as though he is much weaker than last time. I am afraid that he is carrying some sort of wound on him. The man never liked talking much. However, he could not help but feel the necessity to remind her. Jiejian, the commander knows his boundaries. Jiejian was not as tame as him. You have served the commander for so long. How can you still not know him? He knows boundaries when it comes to masses, but he never knew his own when it came to himself. Zhang Xinbodi said nothing but looked at her with a "but what can you do about it" look. Jiejian was feeling distressed, but there was genuinely nothing that she could have done. Kui Buku had always been someone who refused to stop until he achieved his goals. Right now, unless they ran off to Feng Xiao and told him Kui Buku's identity and bring him back home, their only other option was to obey his orders. However, if she messed up his plans, she knew Kui Buku would dismiss her from the Zhuo Bureau. Jiejian only let out a sigh. It is late. Let us go to the perfume shop, Zhang Xinbodi reminded her. Let's go. Jiejian brushed the surface of the table, and those words disappeared. The side of the table was clean as if nothing had ever happened there. There was no shortage of perfume stalls in the city of Six Crafts. Because it was a city that travelers from the west and east often met, there were a lot of things in the perfume shop that could only be found in the west. The variety of products were even more numerous than those in the capital. Zhang Xinbodi and Jiejian previously had thought that investigating the plum blossom scent would have been a piece of cake, but after they ran around for a whole afternoon, practically asking every store that existed in the city, they could only manage to find three formulas that were related to the plum blossom. It is a coincidence now that I think about it. Before you, there was also a young lord who came here asking about plum blossoms. He was thin and tall, seemingly young and handsome. The perfume shop owner made a gesture. Jiejian and Zhang Xinbodi exchanged glances and could guess who the perfume shop owner was talking about. It was Feng Xiao's subordinate, Pei Jing's. Since the Jiejian Bureau had already traced this clue, it could be said that there was nothing more they needed to do. Why did the commander go out of his way to give this order? Kui Buku would never do such a meaningless thing. Both of them felt that there might be something that they had not thought of yet. I would not air comment on other aspects, but within the city of Six Crafts, the formulas in my stalls are assuredly the most organized. If you want formulas related to plum blossoms, there are three types. One of them was gifted by a young lady from the west, whom I saved. She gave it to me. The perfume shop owner spoke, taking out three scented strips. The sense of smell of martial artists was incredibly sensitive. To leave perfume on oneself would give them away effortlessly if they were found out. Jiejian held a distinctive identity, so she would never carry any sort of scent on her. For people like her who interacted as less as possible with perfumes, she was even more sensitive to the odor of perfumes. Almost at once, she could tell how many different scents there were all together. These are plum blossoms and apricot flowers, she smelled the scented strips and asked, before passing them to Zhang Xinbodi. The perfume shop owner nods. You were right. This is called the Three Moons Spring Snow. It is the most popular perfume in the capital. The young maidens all love it, especially those from wealthier households. Come spring, they like to put on fresh colored clothing, then putting these perfumes on. They say it makes you look like a goddess. It is guaranteed that a group of suitors would want to stomp your doorstep. He was a smooth talker. Even when questioned by his customers, he was still trying to persuade them to purchase from him. This type is called the Quiet Waters Runs Deep. It has the smell of sandalwood and plum blossom. It is excellent for giving you peace of mind and suppressing any foul smell of the body, he said as he took up another scented strip. Zhang Xinbodi smelled it and shook his head. Jiejian said, this is not the plum blossom scent that we want. The perfume shop owner took the third scented strip and gave it to them. This is the only one with a pure plum blossom smell. Sangson Bodhi held it in his hand and felt that the plum blossom fragrance was too strong, filling in his nostril. However, it lacked the real cold, icy smell of a plum blossom. Instead, it smelt like peonies. Kiaozian, watching Sangson shake his head, took the scented strip. Sir, you are knowledgeable and have seen many things. This mixture of plum blossom scent, is it indeed that difficult to get? The owner of the perfume shop answered, usually, the thicker the essence of the smell, the better. But because this is slightly different, at first the smell should be a bland, cold, icy smell. Only after an hour would the fragrance of plum blossom slowly emerge, yet you can still smell its faint, icy cold scent. It is neither strong, and it does not dissipate quickly, lasting up to a few days. Kiaozian thought about the fact that after the murder took place, Feng Xiao and his company were able to go to the venue and obtain the clue. The owner's answer fits in with this fact perfectly, so she nodded and agreed. This means that surely whoever uses this perfume is no ordinary person. The owner, there are also different types of cold perfume. For example, the lotus blossom, the bamboo, but because plum blossoms only bloom during the cold winter, it brings with it the icy cold essence of winter. This type of cold is different and very rare. A few years ago, I obtained a particular type of lotus blossom perfume, and I was reluctant to sell it, desiring to leave it as a wedding gift to my daughter, but this plum blossom is even rarer. Whoever could make this type of perfume would indeed treasure it so, and would not have given it away easily. Otherwise, everyone on the streets would know how to manufacture it, and if that is the case, then how is it still special? Kiaozian, then do you know anyone who knew how to manufacture this perfume? The owner of the perfume shop laughed bitterly. If I knew such a person, I would have hired them with gold pieces. Would I still be standing here saying so much to you? Strange wonders can be encountered unexpectedly but cannot be requested. I have spent half of my life in the perfume business, so if you find someone who knows how to manufacture that sort of perfume, please be a generous person and introduce them to me. He stopped for a moment to pat his head. Right. Last month, Lady Yunine from the Spring Moon astounded half of the city with her dance. I have heard that she uses a different perfume every day, yet she has never sent anyone here to purchase from me. Perhaps she might have someone teaching her how to make her perfume. Nevertheless, you can head over there and inquire about it. Kiaozian and Hangsun Bodhi's eyes sparkled. Have you spoken about this to the one that came before us? Kiaozian asked. The perfume shop owner shook his head. At that time, it did not cross my mind. Naturally, I had forgotten about it. Kiaozian, that Spring Moon place, is it a place of entertainment? The perfume shop owner gave a dubious smile that all men knew. Kiaozian immediately understood and felt that the question she had asked was quite ridiculous. Broadly speaking, spices used to make perfumes were also a type of medicine. Since Kuibuku was familiar with the arts of healing, he was naturally accustomed to spices, and he knew that the plum blossom perfume was very rare. From this piece of information, he was able to spread out further finding clues. Kiaozian and Hangsun Bodhi knew their commander very well. Others may underestimate him, seeing how he was often sick and that he lacked physical strength. However, if a person like that could summon winds and storms, making a place for himself in the world, then he would certainly have something that ordinary people would not be able to guess. In the Zui Bureau, even if Kuibuku spent 8 out of 10 days lying in bed, no one would dare underestimate him. Would the members of the Jiejian Bureau vomit blood if they knew that the Five Tastes restaurant is our stronghold? Kiaozian felt better after obtaining a possible lead for the case. Although her face was still expressionless and cold, her voice sounded less tense. Sangson Bodhi did not respond but asked her a question back. The Spring Moon, should you or go? Kiaozian, of course it should be me. With a face like yours, people would think you were there to collect debts, certainly not one looking for entertainment. Sangson Bodhi held the prayer beads in his hand and did not say a word. Because, towards Kiaozian's words, there was nothing he could refute. Lin Lang Guild's Hall. Today was the final day of the auction. Compared to the last few days, there were even more people. However, the threshold was also higher than before. Other than an invitation, customers also needed to give some amount of deposit before entering. If they managed to purchase something they like, then the deposit would be added to the amount they had auctioned for. If nothing caught their eyes, then their deposit would be returned. Therefore, it filtered out a lot of people who had other intentions, or those who did not really want to make a purchase, simply wanting to come for the crowd. Feng Xiao brought Kui Buku and Pagings and entered, just as someone immediately exclaimed from behind, "Is this not Feng Er?" That person immediately ran up to them, both surprised and happy to see Feng Xiao. "Feng Er, long time no see. To think I would see you here." The other man looked around 25 to 26, wearing a tall headpiece and red robes. He looked like an elegant gentleman, but Kui Buku's sharp eyes were able to tell that the way he behaved around Feng Xiao was different from the norm. Meeting old friends was a common thing, but this manner of attentiveness and welcoming was a little off. To think of him as someone who wanted to bribe Feng Xiao was not exactly accurate either. Just as Kui Buku was contemplating, Feng Xiao had already raised his brows and smiled, "Young Master Lin, it has been some time." When these words left his mouth and judging by the other's age, his background and history were slowly emerging in Kui Buku's mind. The Yandang Estate. Among Jianghu Province, their main profile was doing business. Both rich and wealthy, their family also possessed the Yandang 13 sword styles. The head, Lin Lang, only obtained a son, Lin Wei, in his late years, therefore it was natural that he spoiled this child rotten. Even towards his son's bewildered and queer habits, Lin Lang simply remained silent but never obstructed him. The reason that the Yandang estate was so famous was not because of their wealth, and not because of their sword style, but because of Lin Wei. Seeing that Lin Wei was all giddy and happy, practically lunging himself forward to hold Feng Zhao's hand, the latter naturally stepped a few inches away from him, his hand reaching up to place it on Kui Buku's shoulder instead. Before Kui Buku realized it, he was already pulled towards Feng Zhao's body, their shoulders clashing against one another. "Feng Xiao, come, let me introduce you. This is a very intimate friend of mine. His surname is Kui, named Buku. This is young Master Lin of Yandang Estate, Lin Wei." He purposely put more emphasis on the words intimate friend, his lips curling into a strange and unusual smile. It was incredibly suggestive, and clear, that anyone could have seen it.